How you doing? I hope you're doing good. I hope you had a good weekend. I did. My week. Today's Sunday, y'all. I'm recording on a Sunday. I normally don't record on Sundays. You know, I like to just relax. But I didn't record yesterday, so I have to make it up. So, yeah. Yes. How much do Chinese know about the world? Because I know people used to make fun of Americans, saying Americans don't know much about other countries and stuff like that. People like to laugh at us a lot. So let's see how much Chinese knows about the world. They should know. I mean, they're very smart people.
Hey guys, it's Annie from Asian Boss. Many people living outside of China assume that China is pretty isolated from the rest of the world. But have you wondered how much ordinary Chinese people know about the world? Previously, we conducted our street interviews in the US to see how much average Americans knew about Asian countries, which you can check out right here.
And I just did that video. So yeah, check it out. I don't know, I think I might upload it first or maybe this one, I don't know.
Today, we're going to hit the streets of Shanghai to do the opposite. Let's see how they do.
那你如果1到10打分, 关于对于其他国家的一个知识储备, 你给你自己打几分?
3分吧，
因为其实我是文科生，但是我地理不好，1分吧。为什么只有1分呢？我对中国都没有了解的太多，4分吧。去过不少地方，法国、美国、日本、韩国，然后所有的新马泰，但是真正了解的话，谈不上。那我们这边会有一张世界地图，然后就想要你来一起指认看看，想问一下你对这个挑战有没有信心？
有啊，好的，他有的，我没有。首先第一个是美国，那美国应该是在那边，然后应该在这一块，我觉得。美国啊，这。See，they know。美国，这里是那个，这里。好，第二个你知道英国在哪边吗？
大概放在这里啊。英国是一个岛。
这里，爱尔兰。英国和美国离得好像还蛮远的。英国在什么州，你知道吗？我的地理老师，我对不起你，我不知道。
I mean, it's not that far. Is it that far? It's UK. UK don't seem that far. I mean, if I wanted to travel right now to the UK, it'll take me like 8 hours on the plane to get there.
这一块吧，差不多好像是吗？这一块。
我不清楚，应该是你们知道在什么州吗？英国，欧洲，对啊，大概这个方位吧。这里可能是德国的位置，英国是一个岛，你可以再看一下。
对啊，旁边，接下来。
And y'all had the nerve, to be making fun of us Americans. Y'all really had the nerve to be making fun of us Americans, saying that American people don't know nothing about other countries. Look at them, they struggling.
下来是德国在哪边？德国在这，对，跟德国有些了解吗？大概的位置？不太。我猜这个。不对。那就这个。不对。这个。啊。
I can't see it from this map, but I know Germany is somewhere closer to the UK, somewhere in that area, somewhere around there. It's so crazy. When I was a kid, I always thought Germany was like real big. I think I got it mixed up with Russia.
很大，比较大。这个。对了，对了。下一个问题是印度。印度啊？
Oh, that's easy.
印度不是在这吗？你确定吗？
Wait, where was he pointing at?
印度啊，这一大块嘛。
That's Africa. You see what I'm saying? I be telling people like, don't be putting people in my comments be like, oh, America, all the American people don't know nothing about the other countries. They know nothing. Look at them, they struggling.
非洲哦。啊，这是非洲啊。你刚说印度是吗？ 这边。
No. I'm American and I know where India is at. I know where it is. It's right here. Right here. I'm gonna circle it. It's right here. Right here.
这边这个大岛什么？
那里是东南亚。
下一个是巴西在哪边？
巴西在这。阿根廷是这个。
喂，
这不是阿根廷的什么？
这个是智利。
哦，对，这一条是智利，阿根廷比较大。
那巴西呢？
That's a shame. I don't know where that is. I kind of know where it is, but I can't see it. It's not that big.
巴西不是这块吗？
对对对，
巴西。
Wait. Well, it is big.
巴西应该是这边的吧？美洲的吧？是吧？
这是什么美洲啊？
南美。南美吗？这边吗？
不对。
旁边？
对。
下面？好，上面。
南美洲，哥们儿。
我 want some bubble tea。
你搞什么呢？
是哪个是巴西、啊？
是不是这边？
答对了。你是怎么判断出来的？
世界杯的时候会放它的地图的，然后我就知道了。
嗯，好，最后一个国家是尼日利亚。
哦，
那我真是不知道啊。这个吗？
不对。
这个吗？
不对。
这个，反正这个不知道。
你对它有什么了解吗？
非洲。哦，没有了。
It's up top.
对，这么多国家。
It's up top.
那接下来还想问一下，你知不知道有哪些你确定知道的国家可以指给我们看一下？
中国。
还有吗？
日本。
And Japan.
俄罗斯。
嗯。
That's Russia. What's the one in the middle? Mongolia. And then you have China. And then on the other side, you have South and North Korea. Then you have Japan.
不。几个比较靠近的反而懂得多一点啊。
加拿大在这里，蒙古在中国上面，俄罗斯在这里，然后新西兰在这一块，日本在这里，韩国在这里，朝鲜在这里。
经过刚刚的这个挑战，想问一下你们觉得它难不难？
难
在哪里？
就不认识啊，就是我只知道大概的方位在哪里，但是不能精确指出来。
其实也主要就是欧洲啊这些国家，因为那小国家遍布的太多了，确实也不好记，也不好找。
对，那个南美洲吧，
为什么不太了解那边的知识呢？
就对那边好像出来的什么或者电影啊什么各方面的都还比较少。对，
是其实外界对中国有一些固定的认知，会觉得中国因为政治啊或者其他一些因素，就是网络会比较封闭一些。对
，Chinese people don't know much about the outside world. See, I didn't even know. I, to be honest with you, I thought they knew. You know, because these people, you know, they study hard. You know, they, you know, we was told that you know they're very smart people. So I would have thought they knew a lot.As far as know which country is which, but I guess they're so close in to studying stuff in their country. They don't know much about other countries. So, but it is so crazy how Americans, people, so, not Americans, but people say American people don't know much. It's not our fault. Same way, it's not their fault. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
世界的认知不全面，你对这个观点是怎么看的呢？
我觉得大家可以多来中国看一看，然后要切身体会一下才会知道。因为我也有朋友是从国外来中国才知道，原来跟我听说的是不一样的。
我们现在中国互联网的发展已经非常的迅速，然后各方面经济都在往上升吧，可能比以前要好，没有那么闭塞。那就是
Yeah, they shouldn't be so isolated now, you know.
是我们国内的人自己当然知道自己的状况，然后国外的人可能他们不了解，这个也是他们的，就大家共同的一个缺点。
She said every country has a problem. It's true. I've been saying that, but people so always comment below like, I'm like, we all have problems.
那如果你们现在有一些机会，自己想要去了解一些不知道的知识或者不知道的国家，你们会用哪些渠道去了解到这些知识呢？
我觉得肯定是旅游好。就是一边玩还一边的学习嘛。
第二个就是可能找去过那个国家生活或者是有过了解的朋友再去了解一下，然后这样会比较迅速一点。信息
那个搜索引擎
什么搜索引擎？
谷歌、百度。
所以平时会翻
Google? I've mentioned it so much in all my videos, especially when I do these type of videos. I mentioned it so much. GoogleIs your best friend. Want to learn about other countries? Just Google it.
偶尔也会用。
And YouTube, yeah.
YouTube 之类的都会用。
我一般都是油管啊、推特啊、脸书啊
Twitter,
这些嘛。
Facebook,
不过基本上上面都有一些，对吧？毕竟网络嘛，网络的话很多人都会有一些比较主观的那种说法，所以说的话也不能看得有点太确信。
为什么会选择国外而不是选择国内的一些资源？
因为怎么说呢，你说国内资源的话其实也是经过了一定的修改，一定的，对吧，筛选，那可能是有些地方是有些出入的，所以还是要了解确切的话是从国外的网站上了解。
就是我们知道有一些外国人认为我们中国人对世界没有好奇心，不关心外面的世界，你想对这些外国朋友说什么呢？
我们比你们想象的更厉害。
可能他遇见了这种人，但是并不代表我们中国就没有就是对世界地理不好奇的人吧，是这样。就是偏见，我认为他们的观点是偏见，因为中国这么多人，什么样人都有，就是有对这个感兴趣的，也有对地理不感兴趣的。我觉得这个和是不是中国人没有关系，我觉得跟人本身有关系，是这样的。
他不是说中国人就没有，或者是哪个国家的人就没有，就像其实他们外国人对我们中国人也会有好奇心，我们对他们也会有好奇心。
What did you guys think of the answers? Let us know in the comments below. Here at Asian Boss, we try our best to bring you the most authentic insight into the latest news and cultural trends from all over Asia in order to bridge cultural gaps and to build more cultural awareness. We are working as hard as we can to expand our reporting coverage to other Asian countries as well. So be sure to subscribe to Asian Boss and follow us on our social media. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.
I gotta agree with some of them, stuff that they were saying. It's true. You know, it's not their fault, you know, but Google's your best friend. If you want to learn some things, and not just Google stuff, like travel more. You can Google, but travel more, talk to someone that's from that country, you'll learn so much. So when you do go visit these countries, you could be a little bit aware of how the way they live, how their law is over there and stuff like that. So yeah, it's always good to get some type of knowledge before you go to another country. You want to respect their country, you want to respect the people, so it's always good to do your research, watch a few videos on YouTube, like I said, Google, or Facebook, stuff like that, so yeah. But I'm glad I watched this video, I'm glad y'all seeing this, because people always say, oh, American people don't know nothing about other countries. They don't know much about other countries. They're so isolated. They're all about themselves and blah, 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 blah. And look at this. They don't know. They don't know much about other countries. Not saying they don't want to. It's just they probably wasn't taught, you know? It's not their fault. Just like Americans. It's not our fault, you know? They didn't teach us a lot of certain things in school. Okay? but this was fun. I will definitely do more of these type of videos. Comment below. What's the next video? What's the next video? Okay, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I'll see all of you people. Take care of yourself. Bye and peace.